على من تاب، فلم يجعل بينه وبين العباد حائل. سبحانه جعل ما على الأرض زينة لها، وكل نعيم لا محالة زائل. سبحانه حذر الناس من الشيطان، وللشيطان منافذ وحبائل، فمن أسلم وجهه لله فذلك الكيس العاقل، ومن استسلم لهواه فذلك الضال الغافل. نحمده تبارك وتعالى على كل حال وواقع، ونسأله أن يحفظ علينا العقول والأبصار والمسامع. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله الضار النافع. سبحانه جعل في السماء بروجا والنجوم لها مواقع، ومن الرياح لواقح، ومنها المدمر ذو الفضائع، وفي البحار أمواج مهلكات، وفيها الياقوت اللامع، وفي الأرض صخر وحجر ومدر، ومنها الجوهر اللامع، ومن النبات حلو ومر، ومن السموم نواقع، ومن الدواب وحوش كاسرات، ومنها ركاب ومنافع، ومن الناس أهل للمعروف، ومنهم في الشر ضالع، أمور حارت البرية فيها. فالحق إنما هو الصادع. وأشهد أن سيدنا وإمامنا سيدنا رسول الله محمد الذي أقض للمشركين المضاجع، ولد يتيما فقيرا فزهدت فيه المراضع، وشب عفيفا كريما، وأترابه في اللهو مراتع، دانت الدنيا لغيره وأدحفته هو بالمواجع، رأى الأغنام صغيرة وعمل في التجارة أجيرا، فظهر من بركته البدائع، سجد للأصنام قوم والحق في صدره لما يعبدون منازع، فامتلأ قراء بتأمل منه وتحنث لله ضارع، ففاجأه الأمين بقوله اقرأ فأنت بالحق صادع، فعاد يرجف فؤاده من الخوف، والله لن يخزيك الله أبدا، فأنت في الخيرات بارع، صادق وأمين، واصل ورحيم، وللمعروف زارع، إنه رسول الله محمد. صلت عليك ملائك الرحمن، وسرى الضياء بسائر الأكوان، لما أقبلت على الوجود مزودا بحمى الإله وراية القرآن. All praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Peace and blessings be upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We bear witness that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah, the Creator, the Sustainer, the Provider, the Cherisher, the One who gave us everything. And we bear witness also that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the Messenger of Allah, and the seal and the final Messenger of Allah. We are sending our blessings and our salutations to all the Prophets and the Messengers of Allah. And we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as He gathered all of us in His house as His guests, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gather all of us again in Jannah al-Firdaus with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant all of us goodness in this life and in the hereafter as well. Allahumma ameen, ya Rabbal Alameen. It is short time that we need to deal with very important topic in our life. And it is related to our relationship with Allah. It is related to that topic which is, we consider it one of the best actions of worship that you can do to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without exerting too much efforts, without even spending too much money, without even spending too much time. and it gives you the highest ranks in Jannah. You will get the highest levels of Jannah by this act of worship. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned many times, 20 times in the Quran, that type of worship. Allah praise those people who are worshipping Allah through this act of worship. And not only this, it is the quickest way to Jannah, the fastest way to Jannah, it is even quicker than Salah itself. Yes, Salah is one of the most important pillars in Islam, but look at the reward of that act of worship. Allah said, whoever did that worship, he will enter Jannah without even hisab. He will not be questioned about his deeds. No reckoning. No even one single question about all the deeds that you have committed. You will go directly from the resurrection land. From the resurrection land directly to Jannah. Without suffering the question of hisab about all your deeds. And that is why I shared with you the topic of today's khutbah. It is under this title, how to maximize your patience and how to master the art of patience. And what does it mean? We have something, the term in Arabic, it is called sabr. Sabr, most of us, we translate it to patience. But that word, it is very comprehensive word in the Arabic, and it is covering lots of good deeds under this word, sabr. Maybe we can make it closer to the minds of people by translating to patience. But that's not the accurate translation for the word sabr. Sabr can be when you struggle, when you have patience, and when you do something good in your relationship with Allah, when you have a good time also in the worship of Allah, when you strive hard with yourself, that is sabr. When you strive hard with the shaitan, that is sabr. When you are facing your calamities, your hardship, the tribulations, when you are facing the tribulations and the hard times with sabr, that is called also sabr. That is called also patience. But the word sabr is wider than just only patience. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the command in the Quran. And He said, وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ. And I need you to seek help, to seek refuge in patience and in salah. And look at how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala introduced patience even before salah itself. It tells you about the importance of patience in the Muslim's life, in the believer's life, that they need to have patience to accept the destiny of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And not only this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the end of Surah Ali Imran said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, all you who believe, isbiru wa sabiru wa rabitu wa attaqullaha la'allakum tuflihun. All you who believe, have patience in your life. And not only this, He said, wa sabiru, that means maximize your patience. Master the art of patience in your life is not only to be patient, but to practice the patience to reach to the level that you can have the master in that patience. What does it mean? You know, everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us in our life period is very short. We live mostly 60, 70, 80, up to 100. That time is so limited and is so short. And every minute in your life, you are going to be tested. That is the nature of this life. We didn't come here to this life to have the absolute happiness. I told you, there is no absolute happiness in this dunya. The first time that you will get the absolute happiness when you will put the first feet in Jannah. Other than this, there is no complete happiness in this dunya. And life is nothing but test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are going to be tested always, always. Not only Muslims, not only believers, but all the humanity will be tested. Allah called at the beginning of Surah Al-Ankabut, أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ. He didn't say the Muslims, the believers. أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُدْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّا الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. Allah said to you, do you think that the people will not be tested in this life? No, they are going to be tested, and they are going to get that test every single day. You will have a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah, at the end of your life, Allah, at the day of judgment, will know, and He knows subhanahu wa ta'ala, but He will give you the testimony upon yourself, whether you was a true believer or just someone was tricked, someone was lying in his claim. And let me tell you frankly, that whatever you have in your life, it is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah gives you money, that's a test. If Allah took it back again, that's a test. If Allah gave you children, that is a test. If Allah took them away from your life, that is a test from Allah. If Allah granted you peace, tranquility, that is a test from Allah. If Allah granted you a good job and you got lots of money, that's a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you lost that money, that is also a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And sometimes you are in a good health, you are in a good shape, and after a short time, you get weakness. You got a disease. That is also a test from Allah. Allah wanted to know how are you going to respond? How are you going to react with the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So every single step in your life is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And do not wonder. When you get closer to Allah, and I need you to listen to this carefully. Allah said in the Hadith Qudsi, that means Allah said the Hadith, and the Prophet narrated this Hadith. It is called a Hadith Qudsi, a sacred Hadith. It is from Allah. Allah said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ إِذَا أَحَبَّ عَبْدًا إِبْتَلَى. If Allah loved His servant, He will give him tests. So the more that He loved you, the more that you get tested. That is the reality. That's why I'm telling everyone, if you do not have a test in your life right now, you need to feel worried about your relationship with Allah. And as we do in the school, imagine you have a kid and he is in the first grade. So what he will study? He will study 1 + 1 = 2. That is so easy. So the lower the level, the easiest the test. And the higher the level, the most difficult the test. And the higher test, that means a big reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you have a true believer, and he is very closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah is going to test him with such tests that will not be easy at all. That is why it depends on you and your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And no wonder Allah had tested the most highest ranked human people. Allah tested the prophets, the messengers of Allah. So do you think that you are better than the prophets and messengers of Allah? Allah tested them with such way that you can never even handle. You can never even recognize. Look at Sayyidina Ibrahim. Allah tested him. Allah said in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَإِذِ بِتَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ. Allah tested Ibrahim many times. The Prophet Abraham, Allah tested him when he gave him the command to leave his place and to take his wife and his son Ismail to a desert where there nobody, nothing at all. And he responded positively. Allah said, ابْتَلَى وَإِذِ ابْتَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ فَأَتَمَّهُنِ. He fulfilled, he passed his test. So I need you to rethink about what you have in your life. The main goal is to pass these tests. If Allah granted you a child, your test is how to raise him up nicely, righteously. If Allah granted you a wife, if Allah granted the wife a husband, Allah wanted to test you. How are you going to treat her? If Allah granted you a child, Allah wanted to test you. How are you going to feed him? From halal source, or you will just start to steal to feed him, whether from halal or haram, it does not matter. Allah is going to test you. If he took that child back, how are you going to respond and react to the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And how many cases that we saw in our life for people were so far from the way of Allah, and when Allah tested them, they came back. They came back. So that test, that hardship, was something good in their life. Maybe in the meantime, maybe in the current time, you think it is hard. But whatever Allah gave you in your life, you should be thankful to Allah. We are the ummah that we need to say, Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah for everything. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ لَا يَقْضِ اللَّهُ لَهُ أَمْرًا إِلَّا كَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ. It is amazing for the believer. Whatever Allah decided for him, it will be good. It will be good. إِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ سَرَّاءً شَكَرْ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ. If the goodness came to his direction and he was thankful to Allah, that's good for him. وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ ضَرَّاءَ. If he got a calamity, if he got something bad, فَصَبَرَ. Then he practiced patience, that would be even bitter for him. So everything happens in your life. If you have something, if Allah took something from your life, it is just a test. And our life is going to move very fast. Can you remember when you was in your 20s, in your 30s, it passed. So short time and you are going to end that test. And alhamdulillah, you will stand before Allah and you will say, oh Allah, I have passed all the tests that you gave me. May Allah grant all of us goodness in our life. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. So I need you to listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to test you with. Because Allah told us in advance, in the Quran, what are the items that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to test us with. Allah said in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ. Five items. Allah mentioned in the Quran that He is going to test us well. Allah said, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ, I'm going to test you. بِشَيْءٍ, just something, a little bit of. Then he said, min al-khawf, the first item, kind of worry, anxiety, fear. Fear of what? That you may lose something. Fear of what? That maybe you have a beloved one, that you may lose them. Fear of something. Fear of the future. You will always overthinking about the future. That's a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah wanted to know, and Allah wanted to see whether you rely on Allah or you will rely on others. So that is the first thing. Then he said, min al-khawfi wal-ju'. Allah is going to test you with hunger. And hunger is a symbolic word. Allah just wanted to tell you that sometimes you have shortage in money, shortage in food. You cannot, you know, afford getting food. Sometimes it is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah said, وَنَقْصٍ. Then Allah will decrease. Decreasing, shortage, مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ, shortage in your money. That is the third time. Sometimes our life is ups and downs. You don't have. Sometimes you have. Are you thankful to Allah? Will you be thankful to Allah? Or you will keep yelling, screaming, and shouting? And you know what? I need you to memorize this statement. The most ignorant person, the one who complains about Allah to his creation. Can you imagine? Someone complains Allah to some of his creation. Yes. You know what? You know, brother, Allah did that for me. Why Allah chose me? Why me? Allah did so and so. That was so difficult. And he started to complain Allah to his creation. It is a big difference between complaining about Allah and complaining to Allah. Sayyidina Yaqub, when Allah tested him, when he lost his son, the Prophet Joseph, what he said, he had sabr, he had patience. He said, فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ, I should have beautiful patience that I'm accepting the destiny of Allah. And when he lost the other son, now he lost two of his children, what he said? He said, قَالَ إِنَّمَا أَشْكُو بَثِّي وَحُزْنِي إِلَى اللَّهِ, I'm going to complain my grief and my sorrow to Allah. I'm not complaining about Allah. It's a big difference. Whatever you have in your life, I need you to forget this point, that you will live without being tested. That is impossible. Because Allah tested the prophets, the messengers of Allah. Allah tested the prophet Ayyub. Look at how many years he spent in his disease, in his illness. He was sick most of his time. And Allah finally, in the Quran, praised him. And he said, Inna wajadnahu sabira ni'ma al-'abd. We tested Ayyub and we found him patient. He is a good servant. That is what Allah said in the Quran. So there is shortage in wealth. And not only this. وَنَقَصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ. Number four, Allah is going to test you with the souls. What does it mean? You may lose a beloved one. You may lose someone that you love. That's a big test. Maybe Allah gave you children and you will lose one of them. That is a test from Allah. That's why Allah said in the Hadith Qudsi, when the angels took the soul of a child, Allah said, أَقَبَطْتُمْ رُوحَ عَبْدِي فُلَانِ. Did you get his soul? And they said, Ya Rab, yes, we did. Allah asked the angels, and he knows, and he said, how did my servant, means his father, reacted? He said, they said, Ya Rab, حَمِدَكَ وَاسْتَرْجَعَ. He said, Alhamdulillah, and he said, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Then Allah said, Ibnu li'abdi baytan fil jannah wa sammuhu baytul hamd. Then build to my servant a house in Jannah and name it the house of alhamd, of praising Allah. That's a reward. And let me explain something most of people did not think about. Most of people, when you ask them, not most, all of people, do you want to enter Jannah? Yes, I need to enter Jannah. Do you want to die? No. So how are you going to enter Jannah without dying? And not only this, do you need to get to the highest level of Jannah? Yes. Do you need to be tested in your life? No. I hate that test. So how did you get to the test? How did you get to Al-Firdaws Al-A'la, the highest levels in Jannah, without being tested? How did you reach to that level without being tested? You must be tested. And you need to struggle? Yes. Because this life is nothing but test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Test after test. Allah said in Surah Muhammad, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ حَتَّى نَعْلَمَ الْمُجَاهِدِينَ مِنْكُمْ وَالصَّابِرِينَ وَنَبْلُوَ أَخْبَارَكُمْ. Allah said, we are going to test you so we know who struggled and who had patience. So being patient and accepting the destiny of Allah, that is something Allah prepared for you, so you get to Jannah. And as I started my khutbah, the quickest, the fastest way to enter Jannah is to get patient, is to maximize your patience, and to know very well, whatever Allah gave you in this life is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open our doors for His guidance. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help all of us to pass these tests. Allahumma ameen. Ya Rabbi al-Alameen. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah al-Aliyy al-Azim. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليك سيدي يا رسول الله. Lots of questions in this topic may arise that, you know, Imam, how could I differentiate between the punishment and the test? We have two words, looks very similar in the Arabic. When we have bala, and the other one ibtila. So the first one is a punishment, and the other one is a test from Allah. How could I differentiate between the punishment and the test? So I could understand. I know what I'm dealing with. So the scholar said, it depends on you, not the occasion, not the incident. It depends on you. How will you react? If you kept shouting, screaming, you did not accept the destiny of Allah, and you got the calamity, then you left the way of Allah, and you started to shout to Allah, oh Allah, why me? Why you send that to me? Astaghfirullah. If you said so, you have to know that is a punishment from Allah for you, because you did not respond positively. But if it was ibtila, a test from Allah to the believers, you will respond nicely, positively, in a good way. You know what? What's the best word that you can say when you got tested? Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. I thank Allah. I praise Allah for everything He gave me. Whether He gave you money, Alhamdulillah. If He took that money back, Alhamdulillah. If He gave you a job, Alhamdulillah. If He did not give you a job and you are running out of money, Alhamdulillah, for everything Allah gave me. That's the true believer. And you know, when you say, Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un, you are reminding yourself that we are belong to Allah and we shall return to Him. It's short time for the test, then we are going to be happy in the next life. That is the reaction of the believer. And let me tell you something about what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned about sabr. That sabr can take you to the highest levels of Jannah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared a special gate in Jannah for those people who have sabr. They maximize, they master their sabr. When you say, Alhamdulillah. When you say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. When you show the contemplation, when you show that you are satisfied from your heart with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you in this life. And I need you to listen to something very important before we finish this khutbah. What is the most difficult type of tests? What is the most difficult type of test? Do you think losing a child? No. Losing a beloved one? No. Losing money, job, house, car? No. Because you will meet in the hereafter. What is the most difficult test or calamity in your life? This is what Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to make dua, that Allah, he asked Allah and he said, oh Allah, do not make my calamity in my religion. Do not make my tests in my religion. Allahumma la taj'al musibatana fi dinina. And that's my message. As long as your religion in a good shape, don't think about anything else in your life. As long as you have a good relationship with Allah, that is the most important thing in your life. That matters the most. Your religion. And I told you before, that was my message to my children, to my own children. I told them, I do not care any position that you get in this life. I do not care about your certificate. I do not care about what grades you are in. I do not care which level you are in right now, but the most thing important to me is your religion. If you became the president of this country, if you became the minister, if you became a doctor, I do not care. I care only and the most about your religion. If you became the best, in the best authority, in the best position, and you lost your deen, mashallah, you have a PhD, and you do not know how to make wudu. If you got the highest certificate in this life, and you cannot recite Quran, what can I do with your certificate? If he lost his deen, that means you failed as a father. If he had no relationship with Allah, that means you as a father, you did not fulfill your amanah. And be honest, I can see lots of examples like this in our life. So ask Allah the same dua. Allahumma la taj'al musibatana fi dinina. Oh Allah, please do not test us in our religion. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us that knowledge and the wisdom and to know how to deal with such situations. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. Allahumma inna nas'aluka an taghfir lana fi mubala wa israfana fi amrina. Allahumma thabbit aqdamana. Allahumma tawaffana muslimin wa alhaqna bis salihin. واحشرنا يا ربنا في زمرة خير المرسلين. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. اللهم اشف كل مريض يتألم. اللهم اشف كل مريض يتألم. اللهم انا نسألك باسمك الأعظم أن تشفي جميع المرضى يا رب العالمين. اللهم انا نسألك باسمك الأعظم أن تغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا. إنك على كل شيء قدير. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. وأقم الصلاة. قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم.